Recording.
Okay. So my name is Vicky, and I am the CEO and founder of Divas Inc. And Divas Inc. stands for Developing Intellectual Business and Self. It's a mentoring program. I'm 50 years old. I have a son that's 26. I work for one of the top construction companies in Chicago, Mitchell Construction. I supervise the safety department at McHugh, and I supervise maybe on any given day 10 people to 100 people that I can be responsible for. So you're here today to do team talk. Let's talk about it. So today we're going to talk about a lot of the current events. I would like your opinion. You can voice your opinion and do some creative thinking. So let's start with you. Introduce.
Yes.
Before,
you also do a radio show.
Oh, yeah, I forgot that. How could I forget that? I also co-host a radio show, Divas Inc. on intellectualradio.com every third Saturday.
Something
about yourself, like your name, your age, and what school you go to, and something that you like to do.
Mm-hmm. My name is Jarian. I go to Morton, and I'm 14, and I like to play sports.
What kind of sports?
Any sport.
Okay. Young man? did you hear? See, you didn't even hear what I was saying. Tell us. Yeah, I need to know your name. How old are you now?
12.
Okay, so the purpose of doing this is to get you guys to think and voice your opinions and views, without being judged, marked, or scrutinized. Your opinion does matter, and there are no wrong or right answers, okay? So feel comfortable in what you're saying. So we're going to talk about gun laws. What do you know about gun laws for the state of Illinois? Anybody? You should know because you just got homework on this.
You got to have a permit.
Yeah,
you got to have a permit.
Got to have a background check. Kind of, sort of. It's called concealed and carry. What does the Constitution say? Somebody tell me what does that really mean?
The right to carry stuff.
Kind of, sort of. The right to bear arms means you have the right to own a gun. Doesn't mean you have the right to carry it out in the street unless you get a concealed and carry license. So there's a lot of loopholes in the gun laws. So the amendment states you do have the right to bear arms. But everything has to be legal. You can't be a ex-felon and carry a gun. Doesn't work. So the Constitution states in the Second Amendment, a well-regulated militant, which means the police, being necessary to the security of a free state, the United States, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. So no one can take that right from you but you. If you do the wrong things, then you don't get to exercise that right. The NRA stands for the National Rifle Association. It advocates for gun rights and was founded in 1871. It informs its members about all the firearms-related bills and laws. They generate about $3 million a year. They also lobby against all forms of gun control and argue that more guns makes the country safer. You guys think about
that's not valid for every situation because everybody should be able to carry a gun
because everybody is responsible
and everybody's not in the right to not carry a gun.
Anybody else?
Don't be afraid.
So one of the requirements is a FOID card, F-O-I-D, and that stands for Firearms Owner's Identification Card. You have to be 18 years old, no felonies, but just because you have a FOID card doesn't mean that you can carry a gun. It only allows you to have possession of one. To carry one, of course, you need the concealed and carry case. So in the news lately, there's been a lot of things going on in regards to gun laws. Just Tuesday, a high school in Florida, a 17-year-old student shot and wounded two of his classmates, a 16-year-old girl and a 14-year-old boy. So when you hear these things that are happening in schools and on college campuses, what are your feelings about it? Going to Western House and just hearing what I just told you that happened 3 days ago, 2 days ago, on a high school campus. How do you feel about that?
When you just started high school, it makes the majority of us like not feel safe.
Anybody else?
Do you think someone would do that at your school?
Yeah.
think so?
She is.
We are for sale.
We're not gonna name any names, but do you feel?
Is there something somebody said? Like, you don't have to say who, but like, did they say something that made you think that?
Just
the way they
had a response to certain things.
You know, like if they left, like they didn't like you or something.
There could be some concern.
This is a real lockdown. Somebody start laughing.
I think if I had to go to school nowadays, I think I would be a little hesitant about going to school and making it there safe with all the things that are going on. Not saying that someone will do that, but. You guys hear about the young man James Davis Jr.? He killed his parents.
He's picking them up for spring break.
Not James. Mari said give him his charge.
So you mean to tell me you guys didn't hear about that?
I don't really watch those because this would be the same stuff over and over.
Why did they say that Henry killed his parents because he got tired?
Well, the story is that the young man, the police picked him up and took him to the hospital on Thursday in relation to a possible drug interaction or overdose. He was later released and then brought back to campus. On Friday, his parents came to pick him up because they got a call from the school saying that he was acting strange. And in the process of them moving him out of his room, his dorm room, he got his father's gun, was a police officer, out of the car, and went back up. His parents, he has a 16-year-old sister and an older brother that's left, and left without parents. So this is the reason that we are talking about gun laws. Who should be able to purchase a gun?
30 No, guns is everywhere.
I know, but who should be able to legally purchase a gun? Should a 15-year-old be able to purchase a gun?
No. It's no. Like, if you got a clean record, like a clean record, and if you like over like 30, something like that, if you go over 30, you got a clean like record.
So a more responsible adult who has a clean record, what about somebody with mental issues? So how would I know that you're bipolar?
Do a background check. You ain't got to always. It ain't gonna always be on
them. But what if I'm able to pass a lot of tests? You got smart people that have bipolar.
It's like there's no telling.
So that's the question that lawmakers need to think about. Who is really capable of purchasing a gun? Right now, at the age of 18, you can purchase a gun if you got a boy card. So should the age be raised higher? Because now I think you have to be like 21 or something to buy cigarettes. You used to be 18. So you could be 18 and buy a gun, but you can't buy cigarettes and alcohol.
I kind of disagree with that. Cause like, why if you ask your friend to do it? Like buy me a gun, and then you just take it. You might be one age to do it, then that person that's that one age, you ask them to do something.
That Democrats are my favorite.
I'm Erica. I am 30 years old, and I like a lot of things. I like to make beats, and I like to read comics, and I like to garden. I like to do gardening and growing things, and a lot of other stuff too, like talking to you and sitting here right now. I love that.
Cool. Oh, hey, I'm Chanel. I'm 15. I'm at my mother's house. And,
what's going on?
Play basketball.
My name is Mariah. I'm going to Morgan. 13. I like to dance.
My name is Najee. I'm 14. I go to Morgan. I like to play basketball.
My name is Anaya.
How old are you now? 12. Okay, so the purpose of doing this is to get you guys to thinking, what's your opinions and views without being judged, marked, or scrutinized? Your opinion does matter, and there are no wrong or right answers, okay? So feel comfortable in what you're saying. So we're going to talk about gun laws. What do you know about gun laws for the state of Illinois? Anybody? Mm-hmm. You should know because you just got home with guns.
You
got to
have a permit.
You got to have a background check.
Gun license.
Kind of, sort of. It's called concealed and carry. What does the Constitution say?
Right.
Somebody tell me what does that really mean? The right to bear arms means you have the right to own a gun. Doesn't mean you have the right to carry it out in the street unless you get a concealed and carry it. There's a lot of loopholes in the gun laws. So the amendment states, you do have the right to bear arms. But everything has to be legal. Can't be a ex-felon and carry a gun. Doesn't work. So the Constitution states in the Second Amendment, a well-regulated militant, which means the police, being necessary to security of a free state, the United States, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed. So no one can take that right from you but you. If you do the wrong things, then you don't get to exercise that right. The NRA stands for the National Rifle Association. It advocates for gun rights. It was founded in 1871. It informs its members about all the firearms-related bills and laws. They generate about $3 million a year. They also lobby against all forms of gun control and argue that more guns makes the country safer. What do you guys think about that?
That's not valid for everything. Because everybody should be able to carry a gun.
Because everybody is responsible.
And everybody's not in the country.
right, not in the right day, but not in the right day. Anybody else?
Don't be afraid. So one of the requirements is a FOID card, F-O-I-D, and that stands for Firearms Owners Identification Card. You have to be 18 years old, no felonies. But just because you have a FOID card doesn't mean that you can carry a gun. It only allows you to have possession of one. To carry one, of course, you need the conceal and carry case. So in the news lately, there's been a lot of things going on in regards to gun laws. Just Tuesday, a high school in Florida, a 17-year-old student shot and wounded two of his classmates, a 16-year-old girl and a 14-year-old boy. So when you hear these things that are happening in schools and on college campuses, what are your feelings about it? Nobody? Shanae. Going to Weston House. And just hearing what I just told you that happened 3 days ago, 2 days ago, on a high school campus. How do you feel about that? We're not gonna name any names, but like, do you feel?
Yeah. Is there something somebody said? Like, you don't have to say who, but like, did they say something that made you think that?
Just
the way they
acted.
Just how
they
give
it. How they look. How they respond to certain things.
You know, like if they laugh, like they want to like you or something.
That could be some concern.
This is a real lockdown. Somebody start laughing.
Oh, somebody don't laugh.
I think if I had to go to school nowadays, I think I would be a little hesitant about going to school and making it there safe with all the things that are going on. Not saying that someone will do that, but. You guys hear about the young man James Davis Jr. He killed his parents.
He's picking them up for spring break.
Why?
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 It
was on TV. Not Jake. Mari said, "Give him his
charge." It's not coming.
That's disrespectful.
So you mean tell me you guys didn't hear about that?
I don't really watch those because it just be the same stuff over and over.
Well, I'm gonna look.
Why? Then they say that Aaron killed his parents because he got tired.
Well, the story is that the young man, the police picked him up and took him to the hospital on Thursday in relation to a possible drug interaction or overdose. He was later released and then brought back to campus. On Friday, his parents came to pick him up because they got a call from the school saying that he was acting strange. And in the process of them moving him out of his room, on his dorm room, he got his father's gun, was a police officer, out of the car, and went back up. His parents, both of them. He has a 16-year-old sister and an older brother that's left, and are left without parents. So this is the reason that we are talking about gun laws. Who should be able to purchase a gun?
Guns is everywhere. It's those don't have a range.
I know, but who should be able to legally purchase a gun? Should a 15-year-old be able to purchase a gun?
No. It's no. Like, if you got a clean record, like a clean record, if you like over like 30, something like that, if you over 30 and got a clean like record.
So a more responsible adult who has a clean record. What about somebody with mental issues? So how would I know that you're bipolar?
Do a background check.
You ain't gotta always. It ain't gonna always be on
them. But what if I'm able to pass a lot of tests? You got smart people that have bipolar.
It's like no talent.
So that's the question that lawmakers need to think about. School is really capable of purchasing a gun. Right now, at the age of 18, you can purchase a gun. If you got a boy card. So should the age be raised higher? Because now I think you have to be like 21 or something to buy cigarettes. You used to be 18. Yeah, so you could be 18 and buy a gun, but you can't buy cigarettes and alcohol.
I kind of disagree with that. Cause like, why if you ask your friend to do it? Like buy me a gun, and then you just take it. You might be like one age, introduced to that person that's at one age, you ask them to do something, and might get you a couple of cigarettes and smoke. Like that.
Okay. So there's a lot of things that the makers of these gun laws need to really look into before they start making these laws. That's what we're getting at? When thinking about your community, your neighborhood, the block you live on, the street you walk, your school, and your home, even your church, how do you think the gun laws that are coming into the making is going to affect all of that? Will gun laws make those places safer?
No. I feel like, okay, I'm too big.
Every school should have metal detectors.
People do stereotype that you got a metal detector in your school, that means you go to a bad school. But that's not the case.
Should teachers be able to carry guns?
No.
Because if you don't turn a pair of 66, they'll tell you.
If you didn't turn to page 66.
Yes, if they shoot with that.
Some teachers are already crazy. Some teachers already they already have dangerous actions up to store students. So imagine if they had a gun with them.
Yeah, like that girl that got beat in the classroom. That teacher had to do that. Imagine if you got a gun.
So if you were called to make one gun law decision, what would it be? How about you? If you were called to make a gun law decision, what would it be?
There's so many. Beyond just a background check, it was something that you kind of mentioned earlier. It would be like medical evaluations and of course like criminal records, but think it needs to be harder. You know, I'm not a professional, so I don't know exactly what, but we do a lot when it comes to driver's licenses and passports, and so just having a gun needs to be treated with the same responsibility and urgency. Like, you should be able to prove through these, you know, through this series of testing that you are responsible enough to be a gun owner. Yeah.
And what she's talking about is those AR-15s. Those are like machine guns. They have big magazines. I don't think people should have those.
Those are army weapons.
Which is a completely other conversation,
yeah.
Right? We would have to, the thing about guns is that we would have to change an entire mentality. We would have to change an entire spirit of the nation if we're going to, like, you know, have any type of resolve. We have been in a continuous war with someone as a country for years. So it's hard to say that guns are okay over there and not here. You know, it's hypocritical. That's why we don't have the necessary conversations. That's why everything is like a band-aid when it comes to, okay, well, we won't sell this kind of weapon, or we won't sell like bump stops, or we'll ban, you know. We're not getting down to the bottom of the fact that we enjoy violence in a lot of other spaces. Like, it's very American. It's very us. And now that it's bleeding into schools and has been for the past couple decades, we don't even know what to say because smart kids like you all, like the ones in Florida, you know, can rebut that very, very easily.
I watched the comment down on the roof. I don't know. I was just in math. We weren't doing nothing. So I looked it up, asked my dad, like, what was the school shooting when you were younger? He said, comment down. So I looked it up, and it was like some out of a mafia movie. Like, they walked in there and trench coat, just started shooting everything.
That's.
You'll find out that many things that concern our government are like a double-edged sword, good and evil.
Like, I always think about with guns, like, why were guns invented? What was the point of there's like, yeah, what is the point of a gun? Shootings, like, more money you spend on guns and the more guns you make, what do you think's gonna happen? They have one point, right? So it's like the more you make, of course, more people will die.
And we spend a crazy amount of money on the military. When people say that, that's what they mean, you know? When they say you're spending all this money on the military, whether it be over there or even like in police departments, you buy a bunch of stuff and these people are gonna wanna use it, right? Police departments want to use all of their new equipment that they spend millions of dollars on, and so does our military. You have to start using this stuff. I mean, it's a business. It's not like, oh, we need this and so let's make this by demand. There are gun companies today making a bunch of guns that are gonna be out for the public and everything. A great question, because I know that you probably see things on television, and though it may scare you, do you feel how do you feel when you watch that, besides like, oh, I'm in high school? Do you feel like it can happen in your world, or is it something that's more pressing to you as far as gun violence? Like, well, somebody in my neighborhood was shot, or, you know, does that bother you and give you a sense of urgency?
I'll answer that. Yes, it is. I'll share a story. I had a cousin who died 8 years ago. Maybe he was in his early 30s when he died. A couple guys drove up on him and shot him 13 times right in front of his car. So I'm against guns, but then there's the other side with protection, because I feel I have the right to protect myself in my home. You know, so I've had friends growing up that has also been victims of gun violence. My friend lost her son, and he was 15, riding his bike, and a couple of guys that were in their 30s, because he was riding in the wrong neighborhood, shot him 10 times, and he died in.
My cousin, I think he was 19 when it happened. So, my cousin, he's out there on the streets and stuff. But he's out there on the streets and stuff. And like, he doesn't have a gun, but one day he was and they pulled him into a building house and shot him in the head like 2 times. But thankfully he did. But he still has like PTSD and stuff.
Of course he does.
Like, well, one day he went outside and he saw the person he had.
Of course. It's traumatic. And that's the thing that I think about more, just living here in this city. And even if you don't experience it firsthand, you hear about it happening all the time here, which is the same conversation, you know, just about guns and who gets them, who holds them, how do they get here, you know. You hear about the stories of people robbing the trains, or, you know, like these big boxes of guns just falling off into some neighborhood and getting in the hands of
the wrong
people.
How did they get there?
Right.
We're gonna put it over here so we can see.
Well, that's a great question. A lot of police officers do that. And I had this person, I was telling my secretary yesterday, that this person that I knew from high school, you know, I don't know how he was in high school, so I don't want to speculate, but he's a police officer now. And we were at a baby shower a few years ago. And we were talking, had some drinks, and he ended up showing me this gun that he had, like, under his shirt. And I'm like, this is a baby shower. Go put the gun in your car. Like, you're off duty. This is family. Who do you think you're about to shoot? What do you think is about to happen in here? Go put the gun in your car. Which leads me to a lot of times when people have guns, something shifts. Something shifts to, like, a heightened awareness, or you wanting to use it, or you...
You become God. You become that person that decides, basically, I want who gets to live, who gets to die. Because I have concealed carry license. You're taught in that class that if you concealed and carry, that means that I can carry a gun.
Don't you have, like, a license?
I do.
She just...
That's what it's called, concealed and carry licenses.
Then how did you get that license?
I went and applied. And you did a background check. And you had to go to class. You have to do so many hours. They teach you how to break down a gun. They teach you how to carry a gun. They teach you how to aim and shoot. And they prepare you mentally for carrying a gun. But you have to be prepared to carry this gun.
What does that look like? How do they prepare you mentally?
Mentally. Well, when I went to class, he said, why are you here? I said, well, to get my license for to carry a gun. He said, are you going to use the gun? And I said, probably not. He said, so why are you here? You're not going to use the purpose of going to the class is to use the gun. Just basically, because if you're not mentally prepared, you pull out a gun, you're taught to shoot. And that's what they teach you in class. So they kind of like mentally prepare you. You can't stand up there and just be like this. When you pull the gun out, you gotta be ready to shoot. So right then you deciding to me if you're gonna take this person's life or not. And more than likely, you pull the gun out, you're gonna use it. Other people may see it as a form of control. Person could pull a gun out and never use it. People have been robbed before and they pull out the gun, they have control. To me, that's kind of like God. I got control over you right now. Give me your stuff. You don't want to die, you don't want to get shot, so what you do? You give them your stuff. But there's still a chance that they might shoot you. Whether it's my friend, my cousin, I talk to you. Because I have all the stuff being thrown on me. If a guy comes to work and he's man and his wife, they had an argument.
We have a problem.
So I'm going to have to sit down and talk to him so that he can, I can make sure that he's in the right frame of mind. Working next to all that. Because if he's not, then I have to sit him home. Or he goes into the office and do something. Because I can't afford to let him be out there and be a danger to himself and then be a danger to somebody else.
I know I've been in one of those situations where, like, you, like, talk to a person trying to stop, like there was a witness, and I used it, like, one of them, like, in a situation where that witness, like, thought that, like, how, like, in SVU, how, like, I forgot which, like, episode, but the lady that I was talking to, the witness thought that the lady was all acting, like, cute for him to say it. Yeah, the episode where that one lady had to like this with her.
He just said what he thought she
exactly.
wanted.
Exactly. Have you ever been in one of those situations? Then like your boss might get mad at you.
You
might like do something and that woman will like be like, oh my god, and then they be doing stuff, then they be like, I thought she wanted me to do that for.
No, not yet. I don't want to be. That could cause a lot of trouble. No, not yet. Well, guys, let's do this last session. I really appreciate this. So we're going to talk about social media and our president. Our president is our 45th president. Oh, you know the whole name.
That's not my president.
And of course, Donald Trump loves social media.
He doesn't. He needs to get off Twitter.
Excuse me?
Say you got a Twitter.
Yes. Do you guys have Twitter?
No.
No?
I have Twitter.
No, that's mine.
Do you have Twitter?
No, it's mine.
It's Lane?
It's
Lane. It's not Lane.
What do you guys have? Facebook?
Instagram.
Instagram. Instagram is just pictures, right? Hashtags and pictures?
Yes.
It's so time consuming.
I have to sit on my phone for like 30 minutes, 90 minutes.
Yes.
So what do you guys know about President Trump, or number 45? Good or bad? Good or bad?
He likes to, he's a womanizer.
Mm-hmm.
Like, okay.
I heard.
Yeah. And I just thought about this one. He's not the only person that womanizes people, because it happens every day. Like, you can walk in the classroom, and like a boy says something disrespectful. He's a woman. And I tell you, like, if you touch me and I want you to touch me, I say, just don't touch me. Because, like, that, I feel like that's
right. You have that right.
Are you experiencing that now?
That happens. Like, I'm just saying, like, in general, like, that happens every day. People be like you walk in and, like, somebody say something and try to get your attention. Like, mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'm touching you?
No, like, getting your attention. Like,
okay.
You walk down the street. Even when somebody's in a fight with you or something?
Yeah.
Like, they go too far?
Catcalling, hollering,
How does that, like, feel, like, seeing, like, someone that's, like, the head of a country, like, mimic those behaviors?
It makes it seem like it's okay. It makes it seem like, oh, they were just meant to be my wife, and they're just meant to have kids, so why not?
It's concerning.
Because, like, even in class, our dean hires these boys to go to boxes. And I was like, why didn't call no girls? And somebody said, a girl can't do something a boy can't. The girls actually more people being truthfully honest, we carry children, you can't do that. You couldn't say anything you wanted to say at all, because if you say the wrong thing, so
walking down the street singing a song, if you say dropping some type of gang sign, you get in shot. Like, you can't just say anything out your mouth and that's okay.
It's very tense here. That's real. That's real. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Well, why does a grown man not understand these things?
Because he would never talk to you because he was privileged.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Like, your dad gives you a small loan of $1 million when somebody donated $1 million to my school district to make sure that we stay open. It was a small loan.
It's very disconnected, right? He's very disconnected. He's been in his own world for a very, very long time.
And most of that dark behaviors.
I didn't know who Donald Trump was until he was president. I knew who Hillary Clinton was, but I didn't know who he was at all. Me either.
Well, I love him, like his businesses and the Trump Tower stuff. So, and I still think the Trump Tower is beautiful, but I just can't stand the name across it.
And actually, he was the jerk that he is now then, because we got finished with the majority of the work and he filed bankrupt, so he didn't pay us the full price of the building.
And he did that for a long time. He did that with a lot of people.
Yeah. So he goes, and then after that, he gave it over to his daughter. So we had to go to court. My family went to court. And had to settle for whatever small amount that we could get.
And there are small businesses that almost went out of business trying to take him to court to get the money that he was supposed to pay.
And that's what he does.
And that's so sad.
He makes money off of
not paying the debt.
Yeah. He also makes money off of all the mass shootings that happened. He get money from the NRA.
Yep.
That's probably why he's not trying to actually ban regular people from having guns, because he's making money off of other people's deaths.
Yeah, because like when we was, we watched the girl speech, like the speech of the recognized and stuff.
Yeah.
We went to speak to the girl recognized and stuff. And she was talking about, like, I'm tired of hearing that you feel so much about with me. You're not doing anything about it. And like, that really got to me. Like, everybody always says that. Every Republican, Democrat, oh my God, we're just going to pray for what we're trying to do.
To really shape this world to be one that you want to live in. I mean, we all have that responsibility, right? But to have these old guys making decisions for a world in a country that you have to live in. They're about to die.
Instagram's algorithms changed recently.
I thought they had like a blocking thing, like whether you can comment like me stuff on that.
Yeah, but they changed their algorithms from being like so you see everything in order. So if a post doesn't get like at least 30% engagement within like the first like couple of minutes that it's posted, they won't show it to you. Everyone else. So they'll show you a select curated like group of posts, and if it doesn't get like a very large engagement, they won't show it to everyone else that is following that person. So they switched it. Like, so they're like in the process of like censoring people from being able to reach out to their audience that follows them.
So they're saying like
parties eat.
How are you gonna get a lot of people to see your post and just to feel it? You never know your friends acting on social media or if they doing their homework or doing something else that they have.
It's pretty much official jokes that get people with large followings or that people pay a lot of attention to are going to be seen. And then those people are supposed to be seen for 3 to 5 days instead of just like right in the back.
Well, guys, I think we're pulling this up. I really enjoyed it. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you guys have me back.
Of course. This has to be a regular thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's great to be able to kind of unplug a bit and sit in a circle and look at people and talk to people. So, thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thanks to
the participants.
Yeah, thank you so much, guys, for participating. Yeah, absolutely. Having so much to say. Thank you.
But I also want to emphasize that we're always here.
Yeah.
Every day.
Like, one of us is here to talk to y'all. If y'all have something on your mind, mm-hmm. something that's bothering you, or something in the news, you just want to, like, chat with us about it, we like to talk.
You know, being silent is not good. Mm-hmm. If it's something that needs to continue to talk about, I'm sure that these guys here are willing.
And I don't know if I've ever said that. I'm glad that you said that. I don't know if I've ever said that to you guys, but that's the absolute truth, that we're here to talk if you ever want to talk about anything.
It doesn't even have to be serious.
It doesn't have to be serious.
You just got something you want to talk about, and your teachers aren't listening to you. I want to listen to y'all.
This is a safe space.
Like a oven. I'm trying to make a food.
Thank you again.
On that note.
Thank you guys.
Thank you guys.
Bye.
He was trying to make a food joke.
The waffles. The toast and stew.